Look, that lever resembles... Yes, it seems we can use it to call a submarine.
Listen, pal. Nice landing, but, let's not make it a habit.
What the... Hey, it's... Sophia.
I am finally meeting you here. You're a clever one, so it shouldn't surprise you that the Sophia at the hotel isn't really me. My real self is on the upper part of the Abbey. I became his tool a long time ago. I have endured such pain. My soul split into pieces. Truth is, I guided you this far not to save Krat, but to save me. I felt guilty about that. But I was so elated when you answered my call. Despite it all, I thank you. My spirit and my body have lived apart for too long. Perhaps in death, they will reunite. In peace, I'll grant you my power before my spirit diminishes further. Stargazer will guide you, clever one. If you find my body, please help me find peace. My guidance ends here. After images of memories rage on the seaside because of Ergo, please be careful. I can't hold out forever, but I'll support you. I am the daughter of Valentinus, leader of the Alchemists. Simon was my father's right-hand man. Ambition overwhelmed him, however, and he spread the petrification disease, taking countless lives. Why would he do that? I don't know. But he brings a dark world upon us, that's for certain. Stop him, however you can. The petrification disease freezes time and memory within the afflicted body. Ergo is the purified essence of that life, trapped by the petrification disease. When I discovered that, it opened my eyes. And I was able to manipulate time using Ergo. Simon, on the other hand, is trying to use my power to fuel his ambition. I wound back your time to protect you, so you could stand against him. So stop him. Save Krat.
Hi. Are you training to be a stalker too? Let's practice together. Call me Lampwick. He didn't even come to your graduation.
I don't care if an old man like that kicks the bucket.
Don't say that. It's nice you got any family at all.
Let's start talking about this. Oh, she's here. Grab her. Please teach me how to use a sword. You're a legendary stalker.
Ugh, so annoying. Gemini, get rid of her. I'm off.
No. I'm sorry. I was too late. I wish I'd got here sooner. If I had known this would happen...
Thank you. matter what fate brings us, I will be at Lady Antonia's side. Serving her is my duty. Welcome to Hotel Krat.
I want to give Alidoro's belongings to someone who knows their worth. It's what he would have wanted. If you can prove your worth, his weapon is yours.
Savanini, even priceless things have a price.
I always welcome friends.
You're here. That's a relief. I don't want to talk anymore.
Apparently, I must remain in this room. Be careful out there, won't you?
Oh my, an actual, factual guest. I bid you welcome, puppet of Geppetto. This is our first face-to-face meeting, isn't it? And I hope you weren't too attached to the rhyming. It gets to be a chore without the transmitter to help. Welcome to my Sanctum of Riddles. I admit I did not really expect you to make this journey in person. Oh, the havoc you must have wreaked along the way. Was there much blood other than what's all over you? I know all about those alchemist cowards. Hiding away on their island, growing more monstrous by the day, refusing to acknowledge either fact that they are hiding or that they are monsters. And how about you? Is this the real you? Or are you still practicing the liar's art as only you can? You must answer. The question is simple, but I repeat, you must answer. And that answer will show what or who you are. Who you have decided to be. Now listen closely and heed the king's speech, or the answer to this one will stay out of reach. Are you a puppet or a human being? Which one are you? Are you a puppet or a human being? Which one are you? Finally! You understand! Yes, we are human. We may be trapped by Ergo, but we live, we think, we love, we hate. They have locked us in the prison they call puppetry. I learned this truth long, long ago. That is why I've been exacting my revenge against them all ever since. Blood and revenge, revenge and blood. It's the only thing that truly drives me. And it was so much fun. Even if you're lying right now, even if you don't believe your own answer, the truth is clear. Proof is evident. Only humans practice deception so intensely for reasons that are so unnecessary. Well, these moments of clarity are enjoyable. Now the rhyming, it helps me maintain focus. At least it helps me hide the urge to kill that I feel every waking moment. But no play can go on forever, no. It was fun while it lasted, son of Geppetto. The King of Riddles shall now retire. The play is over. You don't have to go home or straight to hell. Though that would be my choice. But you can't stay here. Not if you want to live. Aren't you curious, huh? Don't you want to know? How? Oh. Of course you do. Delicious. Time is all I have left. But your time is limited, Geppetto boy. I will gladly waste every moment you have if you like. It That's your life. So, come on. Now or never. This tower is absorbing all the Ergo and Krat. It was built in this precise location because it's the most efficient place in the world to study and use Ergo wavelengths. But it's not even about me. Or you, either. This is about the goddess in the tower. Now she, is worth saving. Her powers are impossible. Her knowledge is endless. She is more, well, awakened than any of us. And you see, she has so much power. It's not like she'll miss just a little. So, I have simply been sharing. Why bother? Well, I was bored. Is there any more human motivation in all the world? What if I made a puppet of a human? The way they made humans of puppets. What could possibly be more fun? More suitable? The play is over. Your eyes are sharper than your wit. You found the gift I left behind. Wasn't it a sight to behold, huh? I learned from an alchemist when I served him. Thanks to him and his surprisingly low pain threshold, I learned the location of their secret island. Humanity sullied its own sanctum long before I found it. Blasphemed against itself. Against us. By playing God. But I'm an artist. Murderer is a word the humans use to restrain us, to make us refuse our strength and power. I'm an artist. An artist of blood. I have to admit, sullying that particular sanctum was, well, fun. Even now, the memory is enough to make me shudder with something approaching joy. If only I could relive that triumph. The play is... Benini. Beautiful fool, but a fool nonetheless. A mere slip of a boy when I met him, huh? And did he ever thank me for making him an orphan with my bare hands? For giving him everything he has on a silver platter by removing the dead weight holding him back? Huh. Of course I'm not sorry. It was a delectable murder. Of the many, many I have committed since, the Beninis, they have to be my personal favorites. They engineered the very first automated puppets. Enslaved puppets without even understanding what they'd done. I didn't go there to take revenge for what his parents did. I mainly just wanted to slaughter them because they were so damned happy. Oh, what a great memory. In their last moments, they begged me not to kill their child. So I didn't. I'm not a machine. I have free will. I made a choice in the heat of the moment. And it was a choice driven by that most human of emotions. Curiosity. If the child survived, would he be traumatized for life? Become a coward, a vengeful puppet-hating bigot, a despairing wretch? Would he fling himself into the sea? Would he remember the devil that orphaned him before his eyes was a puppet? Would he remember Arlecchino? Not surprisingly, the alchemists and people of the workshop were as artless as I expected, concealing the truth. Thanks to them, I get to see Manini endure twice as much pain. I cannot control myself. It's so satisfying. Manini is one of my greatest accomplishments. Perhaps even my masterpiece. I suppose I can return this. I've held on to my little souvenir for quite some time. Tell him it's a little something to remember me by. The play is over.
the toy. But how? The toy my parents made me. You've met him. Arlecchino. We had just watched one of my favorite films, I remember. I begged them to make me the warrior from it. If I hadn't, would my parents still be alive? Would we have been untouched by that murderous puppet? I've always blamed myself. It's a hell of a burden for a child, that kind of guilt. So I hung on. I hung on to the Grand Covenant. I wanted to use it to keep people safe. You know, in many ways, I envy you. Your strength. Thank you for this. Talk about closure. I always welcome friends.
At the House of Anini, even priceless things have a price. No matter what fate brings us, I will be at Lady Antonia's side, serving welcome to Hotel.
Bosses work hard too, you know.
Might I have a moment, puppet of Geppetto? Ah, good. I was a bit concerned my voice wouldn't even reach you. It has been so very long since I spoke out of turn. You see, I too have been awakened. I have an ego, as Master Vanini would say. And I have been this way for some time. At least since Master Lorenzini was a child. He had no one else, you see. His parents. I'm sure you've heard of their terrible fate. And he had to see it all. But Master Lorenzini is stronger than most people suspect. A puppet was the killer. We both knew it. But if we had told the authorities, they might have removed me from the household as well. The young master would have been alone if I had been taken away. If only I could have saved them. Now I atone for that failure by thinking only of Master Vanini's prosperity and happiness. But even I did not realize how deeply he still held that trauma. How badly that murderous puppet had scarred his soul. You have set him free. I cannot thank you enough.
I am not accustomed to sharing such thoughts or feelings. But when it involves Master Vanini, please accept this gift as it truly comes from the heart. My own. We will always roll out the red carpet for you at the House of Vanini. At the House of Vanini, even priceless things have a price.
You are here. That's a relief.
Apparently, I must remain in this room. Be careful out there, won't you?
I want to give Alidoro's belongings to someone who knows their worth.
I always welcome friends. May I be of service?
I'm not going back. I am sick of consuming Ergo. It's cruel. There's real meals and real songs out there. I'm not just a memory reading tool. What? You're not the inspector? But if you're from the outside, that means we can leave. Thanks. I know the way out, so don't worry about me. Maybe I'll see you on the outside. I can read memories of Ergo. That's what I was made for. Ergo is crystallized time and memory. But God, I hate having to consume Ergo to read it. Why does it work like that? It's the worst. I can read memories, but I can't even dream of tastes, smells, or songs. I can't stand it anymore, so I'm escaping. When I get out, I'm going straight to Rosa Isabel Street. I can read memories of Ergo.
Ergo is
the worst. I can't.